So here is the next topic, system of particles and rotational motion. Okay, when we talk about a body in motion, we are derive some equations regarding motion in a straight line and motion in a plane concept. There we consider only the motion of a body. We didn't consider the equations for particles involved in that motion of a body. Okay, so here we have to know about the particle motion, the particles which are having the body. So the particle motion of a body, how they behave when the body is moving. Okay, so here we have to discuss about system of particles and especially the motion of rotational body. Okay, so here first one, this is translational motion. Okay, here when you have an inclined plane here, so here the box B is move traveling downwards. So here the whole particles in this box moving in same direction, isn't it? Yes. So the whole particles regarding this body of box moving in same direction. So here these are all moving in same direction, and here the particles, the whole particles about this body box B here, so these are all travel with same velocity also at S. So here in translational motion, the all particles, that means the system of particles, are traveled with same velocity. For suppose here you have, in second case, there you have some inclined plane like this, and here you have some disc, not a box. Okay, for suppose you have a disc there, the disc rolls on this plane, then what is the system of particles motion? Okay, can you recognize it? Here the whole particles in the box are moves with same velocity and in same direction. But here, for suppose here is, this is the center, and here you have some P1 particle, this was moves in this direction, and for suppose you have P2 here, this is moves in this direction. So there is a different directions of different particles on the disc, as well as the velocity of particles also differs. So here there is a motion which consists of translational plus some other thing. What is that thing? We have to learn here. Okay, the body moves downwards, okay, with some velocity, but the whole particles contains the body travels with different velocities in different directions, but the aim is that travels downwards. So here you have two different motions. So those are translational plus something. So that something will be what? So here the motion of a rigid body which is not pivoted or fixed. Okay, the motion of a rigid body which is not pivoted or fixed, that means the axis of that body is not fixed, it was freely available through that motion. Okay, so the motion of a rigid body which is not pivoted or fixed in some way is either a pure translation or a combination of translation and rotation. So here the something is rotation. Okay, when you have didn't fixed the axis of that body, okay, that was freely moving, so that's why here the motion of a rigid body which is not pivoted, that means which is not fixed in some way, is either a pure translation or a combination of these two, translation and rotation. So the motion of a rigid body which is fixed or pivoted in some way is rotation. Exactly. Here in this body you didn't fix this axis, so here this body moves with the motions translational or combination of translation and rotation. Okay, if the axis was fixed, that means take an example, ceiling fan. Okay, that axis was fixed to a rope. So there, when the fan is moving, there you have to consider only the rigid body, which is fixed case. Okay, so there is a motion in rotational motion, there is no translational motion, isn't it? Yes. So here, that is the difference between translational and rotational, and both, which is having both the motions. Okay, these are the cases. So here the first concept is center of mass. How you calculate the center of mass of a body? So here, when you consider a body, but there it is contains many particles. So here, for simplicity, we can start with two particle system. The body contains many particles, so here we have to consider just two particles for simplicity of the derivation. So here, consider the line joining of the two particles is to be the x-axis. For example, consider the particles are stayed at x-axis. So here, the two particles with the masses m1 and m2 provided here. So these are the two masses. So here, from the origin, there are located at a distance some x1 and x2. Okay, and the center located from the origin with the distance x. So for suppose, these are the assumptions you have to take, then what is the distance of the center, okay, from the origin? You may consider as center of that object and the, for example, the origin may be located at same point. You may be feel like that. So what is the case? Is it true or not? The center of mass and the origin is located at that same point, isn't it or not? Okay, so is that the topic here we have to discuss. So here x equal to m1 x1 plus m2 x2 by m1 plus m2. Here is the distance x we have to calculate. We did this like this. So m1 x1 plus m2 x2 by m1 plus m2. So if you have masses, both particles masses equal, for suppose consider that a unique body which contains uniqueness in their properties. So they m1 equal to m2. Then x equal to x1 plus x2 by 2. So exactly the middle of that distance gives you the center. Okay, so exactly the distance is average of that particles gives you the center. So here x is like this. If you consider n particles, okay, here you consider for simplicity two particles. So if you consider n particles, then this is the formula sigma mi xi by mi. Okay, from this one. Okay, so if you consider three particle system, then what is that? Okay, I equal to 3, put. Okay, if you using coordinate geometry in 3D motion, then the distance of the distance of particles in x-axis, consider in y-axis, and consider in z-axis. M is the total mass of that body. Okay, this sigma I means masses of individual particles. So this gives you the total mass of the body. Okay, so here combinedly write with an usage of position vector ri bar. Okay, you have to write with the use of position vector here. Okay, so here we know the concept position vector in earlier cases. So here ri is the xi I bar plus yi j bar plus zi k bar. Okay, position vector of ith particle. For suppose consider here r is the position vector of center of mass capital R. So here capital xi bar plus yi bar plus zk bar is the position vector of center of mass. Then r equal to sigma of mi ri by m, total mass. So here rigid body contains many particles, so solution can be complicated, isn't it? Yes. So here you have I is very much greater, I mean very much value, that means located with some infinite particles, then what is the solution? That becomes complicates your derivation. So the bulk rigid body can be divided into small bodies first, okay, with continuous distribution of mass. Okay, the bulk body M is distributed with small masses like del M. Okay, so here del M to del MN are the small bodies masses. So from that you can derive these x, y, z expressions. These are the coordinates of center of mass, okay, x, y, z. So if n is large, then you have to integrate them to derive such an equation, integrate them. So then the values are becomes integration of dm, that means sum of del mi gives you the whole mass of the body as well, like this. What are the coordinates? Okay, so the vector expression which is equivalent to above scalar expressions is r equal to 1 by m integral of r dm. So if the body is very large, very much large, then you have to derive with this equation. If that body is contains some finite number of particles, then you have to consider this equation is okay. Then if we choose origin as the center of mass location, okay, that means yeah, I asked that question earlier. So that was, if we choose origin as the center of mass location, that means what? Here r equals to 0, because these integrate x dm, integrate y dm, integrate z dm, these values becomes 0. Why? The limits are equal, okay. So that center of mass location is gives to the origin, okay. Here, the point for which the integral itself 0 is the center of mass. Is it correct? Yes. The point for which the integral itself is 0 is the center of mass. So the homogeneous bodies moving its center of mass at origin. So this is the case for which bodies the center of mass is to be origin. That is this case. So the homogeneous body having its center of mass at origin. This is the conclusion. So you have to remember those things. Okay. Thank you.